You know, when I was first saved, and we talked about just briefly last time how I got saved in jail and I was vindicated and set free.
But
when I first came out, I had very little money. I lost everything that I had defending myself from these false charges. And I remember it was my birthday. My daughter was three years old at the time. So we went out and had dinner at Red Lobster or somewhere. And it was all just, you know, just splurging on my birthday. We came out of the restaurant, and I ran into what I didn't know then, but I know now, was what I call an undercover angel. Because the Bible says that we're going to entertain angels unaware.
Yes.
And so this undercover angel came up to me and said, "Do you have any money?" Of course, I had no money. And so I thought for a second. I turned back around. I said, "You can have this food if you're hungry." Because it looked like a person that was disheveled and needed help. And so I gave them my food, the leftovers of my food. And I turned around because I found like $5 in my pocket. And I went to give them this $5. Gone. Absolutely gone. And I really feel like the Lord sometimes will use those experiences to bless us, to get something to us, because we've sown. And even though it's an angel, we've sown. We gave up something. We sacrificed something. And so, you know, when this book idea came out, it was actually Tom's idea. And the reason why this is so, one of the reasons why this is so, so controversial is because of all the angel controversies in the body of Christ. William Branham, a powerful prophet, you know, he had an angel, but then he went off in the last days. You know, we had a revival in Florida, many of you are aware of, where there was supposedly a female angel speaking to the preacher and giving him his sermons, you know, every night. And then he ended up falling into sin. Mm-hmm. And that became something where then people began to get very concerned about angel extremes. So there's been a lot of extremes in the body of Christ with people taking sort of a new age bent on angels. But it's time to redeem the teaching on angels. We must recognize and value the ministry of angels because God does.